Welcome you all. Today we are going to start with the second chapter of Ashtanga, that is Dinacharya Adhyaya. So to start with the chapter, you should know what are the contents of this chapter. So first topic, what you are going to read is Brahma Muhurta. Second, Tanta Dhavana, Saviranjana, Rasanjana, Nasya, Gandusha, Tambula Sevana, Abhyanga, Vyayama, Udvartana, Snana, Dashvid Papakarma, and Sadvrita. So this question in exams come for long essay, explain Dinacharya Adhyaya. So in that first you should know what are the contents of this chapter. So you should remember all these contents in order. Now coming to the first sloka, Vagbhata says, Brahma Muhurta Uttishthe Swastho Rakshartham Ayushya. To protect one's own health, one should get up in the Brahmi Muhurta. So Brahmi Muhurta is the time which can be considered as early morning. The commentator of Ashtanga Hridaya says, Ratrehe Chaturdasho Muhurto Brahmo Muhurta. That is, 14th Muhurta Kala of the night is called as Brahmo Muhurta. So this is a big calculation behind this, but in short, you can remember Brahmi Muhurta means the early morning, 4:24 is the time. So one should get up at this time to protect his health. Next step is Shaucha Vidhi. Sharira Chintam Nivritya Krita Shaucha Vidhistataha. Keeping in view condition of his body, the individual should pass urine and feces. He should get fresh. Third is Danta Dhavana, that is cleansing of teeth. This is very, very important. It comes for 2 marks and 5 marks in your exam. So first you should remember the names of the drug mentioned by Acharyas. Then he is explaining about the size of the twig which is used for Danta Dhavana or for teeth cleaning. And next he is telling about the benefits. So Arka Nyagrodha Khadira Karanja Kakubhadijam Prataha Bhuktva Chamrdu Agram Kashaya Katutiktakam Kanini Agra Samasthalyam Pragunam Dwadashangulam Bhakshayet Danta Pavanam Danta Mamsana Abadayan. So Danta Pavanam is, it is nothing but Danta Dhavana. Now this shloka is divided under the following heading for the easy understanding. So the Danta Dhavana twig, so the twig which you are using for cleaning of your teeth should have the rasa, that is Kashaya Katutikta. It can be prepared from the drugs like Arka, Nyagrodha, Khadira, Puga and Kebuka. Length of this twig is Dwadashangulam, that is 12 angulas. Thickness of this twig should be Kanini Agra Samasthalyam, that is tip of little finger. Then what is the shape? Bhakshay Danta Pavanam. The top of the twig should be made like a brush by chewing. Precaution. Teeth should be cleaned without hurting the gum. That is, Danta Mamsana Abadayana. Abada means should not hurt the gums. Now, contraindications. People who are not supposed to do Danta Dhavana are Natadhyat Ajirna Vamathu Shwasa Kasa Jwara Arditi Trishna Asyapaka Hritnetra Kshiraha Karna Amai Chatat. The following persons are contraindicated for Danta Dhavana, that is Ajirna, those who are suffering from indigestion, Vamathu, vomiting, Shwasa, dyspnea, Kasa means cough, Jara means fever, Ardita, facial paralysis, Trishna, thirst, Asyapaka, mouth ulcers, Hritnetra, Karanamayi, patient suffering from disease of heart, ear and nose. So here the word Amaya, Amai means the disease. So after Danta Dhavana, next is Saviranjanam. Saviranjanam Nityam Hitamakshinastato Bhavit. That means Saviranjana should be done every day. Benefit, it is good for the eyes. Now, what do you mean by the Anjana? So Anjana is a separate chapter which you are going to study in Ashtanga Hridaya. So in short, now you can remember Anjana is a technique which is done from... So for example, this is the eye. So this is called as the lateral canthus of eye is called as Apanga Sandhi. The medial canthus of the eye is called as कनीनिका संधि. सो अंजना एक्चुअली इट इज नथिंग बट द पुटिंग इट, इट इज अ टाइप ऑफ ए काजल. सो फ्रॉम कनीनिका टू अपांग, फ्रॉम द मीडियल कैंथस टू द लेटरल कैंथस ऑफ द आई, यू आर पुटिंग दिस अंजना और ए टाइप ऑफ मेडिसिन बाय यूजिंग अंजन शलाका, दैट इज ए स्टिक विच इज यूज टू apply for this anjana. So this is called as anjana. There is a detailed chapter in the Ashtanga there which you will read. Next is rasanjana. Yojayat saptaratre asmat sravanartham rasanjanam. It should be done once in a week. Nasya, it refers to the administration of nasal drops into each nostrils. So nasya vidhi also separate chapter in your text. So nasya is nothing but putting the medicated drops into the each nostril. So it is usually done for the disease of the urdhvanga, that is upper part of the supraclavicular region. Next is gandusha. It refers to withholding medicated liquid into the mouth. So gandusha is defined as mukha asancharyate yatu matra sa gandusha, that is you have to just withhold the liquid in your oral cavity and spit after a particular time, that is called as gandusha. Tambula sevana, it refers to chewing of betel leaf. So following are the contraindicated for tambula sevana. So people suffering from injury, shata, pittasara, bleeding disorder, ruksha, utkupita, chakshusham, dryness and redness of the eyes. These people are not supposed to take the tambula. Next is abhyanga. This is very very important for exam point of view. Abhyangam acharet nityam. Abhyanga should be practiced every day. Sa jara shrama vataha. It removes old age, exertion and subsides vata. Vata means we subside vata. Drishti prasada, it nourishes the eye. Pushti, ayu, swapna, sutva, dadirekrit. It gives you the strength, it gives long life, induces good sleep and nourishes the skin. So these are the benefits of abhyanga. Now contraindication, people who should not do abhyanga are Varjo Abhyanga Kafagrasta Krita Samshuddhi Ajirnivihi. Those who are suffering from the Kafajvyadhi, those who have undergone purificatory process, those who are suffering from indigestion, these people should not undergo Abhyanga. Now the question is, why the people who are suffering from Kafadosha should not undergo Abhyanga, or why the people suffering from Ajirna should not undergo Abhyanga? For that, Bhagavata has given the reason. So abhyanga, we are using the sneha, any kind of sneha dravya oil we are using for abhyanga. So that oil is having the snigdha guna, and you know that the guna of kapha, it is also snigdha. So if a person is suffering from kapha disorder, if you are giving abhyanga, then the snigdha guna of the body will increase, and that will further increase the kapha dosha, and his disease may get aggravated. That's why person suffering from the increase of kapha or kapha dosha vyadhi, abhyanga should not be done. If you are doing, it will leads to the increase of kapha dosha. Same way in case of ajirna, that is indigestion, a person suffering from ajirna, ajirna also, it is an increased snigdha guna, indigestion. And when you are giving abhyanga, so abhyanga again, you are using the oil, that is also snigdha. So when you are using this, both of this will increase indigestion once again. So that's why it is contraindicated. Next is vyayama. This also very very important. Lagavam kama karma samarthyam, deepto agni medasa shaya. Vibhakta dhana gatratvam vyayamat upajayate. Vyayama gives the following benefits, that is lagavam, lightness of the body, karma samarthyam, increases stamina to do the work, tipto agni, it increases the jatragni, medasa kshaya, decreases excessive fat, vibhakta dhana gatratvam, improves the body physique. So what are the conduct indications of vyayama? Vata pitta amayi balo vriddha ajirno chattam tejet, that is vata pitta amayi, person suffering from vata and pitta disease, ajirna, those who have indigestion, bala, in children's and vriddha in old age people. These people, vyayama should not be done. Now next is explain about Ardha Shakti Vyayama. Ardha Shakti Vyayama means how much a person should do the exercise so that it should not harm his health. Ardha Shaktya Nishevyastu Balibihi Snigdha Bhojibihi Shita Kale Vasantecha Mandameva Tato Anyata. The following people should do Ardha Shakti Vyayama, that is Balibihi, those having good strength, Snigdha Bhojibihi, those who consumes more fat-rich diet, Shita Kale Vasantecha in cold and spring season, Mandameva Tato Anyata, in other seasons it should be done mildly. So Ardha Shakti Vyayama also explained by Acharya Sushruta even Charaka. So Ardha Shakti Vyayama means when a person is doing exercise, so he will start getting sweat over his forehead. So when the sweat comes over the forehead, that means he should stop the exercise. He should not do the further exercise, so it may harm his health. If at all a person doing Ati Vyayama, then it will lead to Trishna, Kshaya, Pratamaka, Rakta Pitta, Shrama, Klama, Kasa, Jara and Chardi. Ati Vyayama Vyapat. So Acharya Bhagavata has given one simile. If a person is doing excessive Vyayama without knowing his strength, then it will result into loss of sleep, sexual intercourse, too much of laughing, speaking or such other strenuous activities. So he is explaining what can be the Ati Vyayama, which comes in the Ati Vyayama categories, and that will lead to just like a lion being destroyed while attacking an elephant. So that's why one should avoid doing the Ati Vyayama. Next is Udvartana. It is a dry powder massage. So Udvartana is usually done to decrease the Kapha Dosha. If Kapha is increased, then we should advise Udvartana. It will reduce the Kapha because of its Ruksha Guna. So that's why Udvartanam Kapharam Medasaha Pravilayanam Sthiri Karananganam Tokha Prasad Karamparam. So since it is having the Ruksha Guna, the drugs which are used for Udvartana are Ruksha, Ushna and Tikshna. That's why they subsides Kapha, Medasa Pravilayanam, melts out the excessive fat, Sthiri Karananganam, stabilizes the body part, Tok Prasad Karam, nourishes the skin. So Udvartana we are always doing for the, in case of Medaroga or in the case of obese people, where the Meda and Kapha is more. So we want to subside Meda and Kapha. That's why we should advise Udvartana, which contains the drug having Ruksha and Ushna qualities. Next, Snana, Deepanam Vishyamayusham, Snanam Urja Valapradam, Kandu Malashrama Sveda, Tandra, Trita, Daha, Papmaje. So, bathing gives the benefits like Deepana, Vishya, Ayusha, Urja and gives the strength. Kandu Malashrama Sveda, Tandra, Trita, Daha, Papmaje. It helps to get rid of itching, that is Kandu, Mala, sweat, tiredness, thirst, burning sensation and microbes. So papma are considered as microbes. Precautions while taking bath. Ushnambu adha kayaha kayasya parisheko balavaha tenaivatta uttamangasya balahrit kesha chakshusham. Pouring warm water below the neck gives the strength, but if warm water poured over the head is causes the loss of strength of the eyes and hairs. That means the hot water bath should always be done below the neck. You should not try to do it from the shiras. If you do so, then it will lead to the loss of strength of eyes and hairs. Contraindication for bath, that is ardita, netrasya karnaroga, atisara, admana, heenasa, ajirana and bhuktvadya. That is immediately after food you should not go for bath. Now this is one of the very important topic for first years, dashvit papa karma. So these are the 10 sins a person should not do, that is Himsa, Steya, Anyatha, Kamam, Paishanyam, Parusha, Anritam, Sabhinna, Lapam, Vyapadam, Avidyam, Drivipareyam, Papam, Karameti, Dashada, Kaya, Vak, Manas, Tejet. So the 10 sins are Pap Karma. So this whole 3 lines of Shloka can be divided under the 3 headings, that is Kayik, Vachik and Manasik. So Himsa, Steya and Anyatha, Kamam, these are the Kayik Papa Karma, Invachik, Paishunyam, abusive words, Parusha, Anritam comes in Vachik, and Manasik, Vyapad, Abhidya, and Drik Viparyam. So these 10 makes the Dashvit Papa Karma very important for exam point of view. Next topic is Sadvrata. Sadvrata means it is a code of conduct which a human being or a person should follow. So there are so many shlokas explained by Bhagavata in this chapter, but I have taken the selected shloka which are important for you to know. So one should always eat and only after the digestion of previous food. So that means you should not keep on eating whole day. If I am taking breakfast in the morning, once it gets digested, then you should have the meal. So after digestion of previous food, only you should eat the food. One should not natural urges forcefully. You should not try to expel the natural urges forcefully. One should immediately attend the natural urges. One should undergo the treatment of the disease as soon as possible. Then another sadvrata, sukhartha sarvabhutana matha sarva pravartaya sukham chana vina dharma dharma tasmat dharma parabhavet. The activities of all the creatures are to attain happiness. However, there is no happiness without dharma. So one should always do the good thing for the others. That is only called as dharma. Same way, those who have no means of livelihood, who are suffering from the disease, who are afflicted with grief, should be helped. That means you always try to help the needy people. Those who need help, you should help. Even the insect ants should be seen with respect, similar to physician, kings and guests. So give the respect to each and every creature of the universe. Help the people who are in need. So that is also called as Sadvrata. So likewise, so many points are explained. One more interesting point is told here. Speak on the right occasion. Speak good words. Speak little. Don't argue. Don't say untrue things. So this is very, very important. You can try to bahead these five words for Sadvrata. So these are all points which you can see in this video. It is also there in your textbook. So as per your convenience, to make it easy, I have written all the points in a very easy way. So you can remember Purvabhibhashi, Sumukha, Sushila, Karuna Mridu, Naika Sukhi, Na Sarvatra Vishrabdo, Na Cha Shankita, Na Cha Nisnehatam Prabho. So likewise, you can try to read all the details of this particular topic of Sadvrata. So whatever good acts you are doing right from your childhood, giving respect to the elders, going to the temples or religious place, giving your oblation to the God, okay, feeding the people who are in need of the food. So whatever the good things you are hearing or you are doing right from your childhood, if you keep writing all those things in the point wise, it will become Sadvrata. So this is also very, very important shloka. Acharya sarvacheshtasu loka eva hi dhimataha anupuryatam evato lokike arthe parikshakaha. For an intelligent person, the world is a teacher. Hence, one should intimate the world after carefully considering their meaning and effects of such condition. So everything in the universe can be your teacher. Only thing is, you should try to understand and learn from each and everything of this universe. Ardha santanata tyagaha kaya vaka cheta samdamaha swartha buddhi pararteshu paryaptam iti sadvritam. One should be compassionate with all living beings, do the charity, controlling the bodily activities, speech and mind, looking after the interest of others as his own. This code of conduct is enough to follow. So with this, we are going to finish the second chapter of Ashtanga, that is Dinacharya Adhyaya. So whichever shlokas I have mentioned except in Sadvrata, try to bahat those shlokas like about Snana, Sadvrata, Brahma Mahurta, Danta Dhavana. These are very, very important for exam point of view. So tomorrow I will upload the video of the third chapter, that is Ritu Charya Adhyaya. So thank you one and all for seeing this video. Thank you.